I remember you, precious Jesus. I remember you, healer of my heart, lover of my soul.
Welcome to First Lutheran Church, where you're among friends in Christ. I'm Reverend Thomas Rothe. I'm glad you've joined us today, and it's my prayer that the Holy Spirit, working through the gospel, touches your heart and changes your life. May the Lord bless you today and throughout the rest of the week. Our first, or Old Testament, lesson is recorded in the Old Testament book of 1 Kings. We read the third chapter, beginning at the fifth verse. The Lord offered King Solomon whatever he wanted. Solomon did not ask for earthly props in which the world places its trust. He was struck by his solemn, God-given responsibility, as well as his own inability. Solomon first sought God's kingdom by asking for a heart that would lead God's people God's way. God granted him his prayer, and then added everything he had not asked for. We read, at Gibeon, the Lord appeared to Solomon during the night in a dream. And God said, ask for whatever you want me to give you. Solomon answered, you have shown great kindness to your servant, my father David, because he was faithful to you and righteous and upright in heart. You have continued this great kindness to him and have given him a son to sit on his throne this very day. Now, Lord my God, you have made your servant king in place of my father David. But I am only a little child and do not know how to carry out my duties. Your servant is here among the people you have chosen, a great people, too numerous to count or number. So give your servant a discerning heart to govern your people and to distinguish between right and wrong. For who is able to govern this great people of yours? The Lord was pleased that Solomon had asked for this. So God said to him, since you have asked for this and not for long life or wealth for yourself, nor have asked for the death of your enemies, but for discernment in administering justice, I will do what you have asked. I will give you a wise and discerning heart, so that there will never have been anyone like you, nor will there ever be. Here ends our first lesson. Teach me, O Lord, to follow your decrees. Give me understanding, and I will keep your law. Direct me in the path of your commands. Turn my eyes away from worthless things. Fulfill your promise to your servant. How I long for your precepts. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son,
and to the Holy Spirit,
as it was in the beginning,
is now, and shall be forever.
Our second, or epistle, lesson for the day is recorded in Paul's letter to the Romans. We read the 8th chapter, beginning at the 28th verse. This really is the most comforting gospel for the trembling believer in Christ. Before he created us, God knew us and destined us to be his. In this life, he called us to faith by the gospel and justified us. Even now, there are no accidents in life, no blind twists of fate. God turns Satan's evil into good for those who love him. If our gracious God has so carefully forged each link in the chain of salvation, we can be sure that he will not forget the final link. He will bring us to his glory. We read, "And we know that in all things, God works for the good of those who love him, who have been called according to his purpose. For those God foreknew, he also predestined to be conformed to the image of his Son, that he might be the firstborn among many brothers and sisters. And those he predestined, he also called. Those he called, he also justified. Those he justified, he also glorified." Here ends our second lesson. Alleluia. Lord, to whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life. Alleluia. The gospel lesson for the day, of which the first portion will serve as our sermon text, is recorded in the Gospel of St. Matthew. We read the 13th chapter, beginning at the 44th verse. The parables of the hidden treasure and the pearl show us the great value of Christ's kingdom. The trusting heart will joyfully sacrifice everything to keep from being separated from it. God's kingdom, like a net, attracts both believers and unbelieving hangers-on. How precious our faith in Christ is as we prepare for our final destination, that being heaven. We read, "The kingdom of heaven is like treasure hidden afield. When a man found it, he hid it again, and then in his joy went and sold all he had and bought that field. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a merchant looking for fine pearls. When he found one of great value, he went away and sold everything he had and bought it. Once again, the kingdom of heaven is like a net that was let down into the lake and caught all kinds of fish. When it was full, The fishermen pulled it up on the shore. Then they sat down and collected the good fish in baskets, but threw the bad away. This is how it will be at the end of the age. The angels will come and separate the wicked from the righteous and throw them into the blazing furnace, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. Have you understood all these things? Jesus asked. Yes, they replied. He said to them, therefore, every teacher of the law who has become a disciple in the kingdom of heaven is like the owner of a house who brings out his storeroom new treasures as well as old. Here ends our gospel lesson. Grace, mercy, and peace be unto you from God our Father, and from our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Once again, our sermon text for this morning is the first part of today's gospel lesson. Dear Christian friends, what are some things that you consider valuable? Maybe it's a possession, like gold. Television commercials keep telling you to buy gold to secure your financial future. Or maybe it's not something that you can buy, like a relationship. It's hard to put a price tag on a marriage or a close friendship. Or maybe it's something else. The portion of God's Word that we have before us this morning focuses on something that's valuable. Using two parables, Jesus shows us just how valuable His kingdom is. This morning, then, let's meditate on the theme, how valuable is Christ's kingdom? We'll see, first of all, that it's as valuable as treasure hidden in a field. And secondly, it's as valuable as a fine pearl. The section from Matthew's gospel, from where our sermon text is taken, has one parable after another. Do you remember what a parable is? From the definition that we learned way back when, a parable is an earthly story with a heavenly meaning. In other words, it's a story about things here on earth that teach us a truth about Christ's kingdom. His kingdom that's located in the hearts of his believers. The two parables are the parable of the hidden treasure and the parable of the fine pearl. Jesus tells us, the kingdom of heaven is like a treasure hidden in a field. When a man found it, he hid it again, and then in his joy went and sold all he had and bought that field. How valuable is Christ's kingdom? First of all, it's as valuable as a treasure hidden in a field. Jesus uses an example from everyday life. It was a common practice to bury something of great value so that it couldn't be taken from you. But what if this person buried something but didn't tell anyone that he had buried something and then died? That treasure would remain in the ground and be of no value until it was found by someone. Then it would have value again. The treasure mentioned in Jesus' first parable has great value. What did the person do who found it? He quickly reburied it, went and sold all he had, and then bought that land that held that treasure. This earthly story teaches us a truth about Christ's kingdom. It's as valuable as a treasure hidden in a field, and even more valuable. How valuable? Just as this person sold all he had to obtain this treasure, we are to be willing to give up everything to obtain the treasure of Christ's kingdom. Now, this isn't the only place in Scripture that teaches this truth. We hear in Luke's gospel, sell your possessions and give to the poor. Provide purse for yourself that will not wear out, a treasure in heaven that will not be exhausted, where no thief comes and no moth destroys. How valuable is Christ's kingdom to you? What would you be willing to give up to obtain the treasure of Christ's kingdom? Would you be willing to give up all of your wealth? Do you remember when a rich young man approached Jesus with the question, what good thing must I do to get eternal life? Do you remember Jesus' response? Go, sell your possessions, then come follow me. This rich young man went away sad because he loved his wealth and possessions more than he loved Jesus and Jesus' gift of eternal life in heaven. Now, while you and I haven't been asked to give up everything in order to obtain Christ's kingdom, could you? That would show that you really love Jesus and his gift of eternal life in heaven. It would show that you've learned Jesus' important lesson that Christ's kingdom is even more valuable than treasure hidden in a field. Jesus continues, "Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a merchant looking for fine pearls. When he found one of great value, he went away and sold everything he had and bought it. How valuable is Christ's kingdom? It's also as valuable as a fine pearl." Jesus uses another story from everyday life to teach an important truth about his kingdom. This time it's about a merchant looking for a fine pearl. Now, not all pearls are fine. It's the job of the merchant to search and find a pearl and then determine if it has value or not. Obviously, the pearl mentioned in our parable had great value. What did the merchant do after he had found it? He hurried off, sold all he had, and bought that pearl. This parable, too, teaches us an important truth about the value of Christ's kingdom. It's as valuable as a fine pearl, and even more valuable. How valuable? Well, just as this merchant sold all he had to purchase this treasure, we are to be willing to give up everything to obtain the treasure of Christ's kingdom. This idea of being willing to give up everything to obtain the treasure of Christ's kingdom isn't new. What did those fishermen, soon to become disciples, do when Jesus called them? Peter tells us, "We have left everything to follow you." Matthew left his lucrative occupation of tax collector. Luke left his profession of doctor. Do you think it was easy for them to do this? Jesus did give them some incentive, though. "I tell you the truth, no one who has left home or wife or brothers or parents or children for the sake of the kingdom of God will fail to receive many times as much in this age and in the age to come, eternal life." That's how valuable Christ's kingdom is. It gives eternal life. Now, even though we can't put a price tag on eternal life, God the Father did. He sacrificed his one and only Son to pay the debt of sin mankind owed God, so that all mankind could be spared sin's punishment of death and be awarded eternal life. How valuable is Christ's kingdom to you? Do you look as hard as this merchant in our parable who looked for a fine pearl? Maybe other ways of asking the question might be, do you make it to church as often as you can so that you can be nourished through the gospel in word and sacrament? Do you include attending a church-led Bible class so that you continue to grow in your knowledge and understanding of Scripture? Do you religiously read your Bible and a devotional book like our daily meditations at home? The merchant in our parable realized the pearl's value, and nothing was going to stop him from obtaining it. In this connection, I can't help but think of the time Jesus announced that he was going to be visiting the home of Mary and Martha. Martha busied herself with making sure that everything was just right for when Jesus got there. She also knew that there were going to be more preparations once Jesus had arrived. But where was Mary? She was at Jesus' feet, listening to the treasure of God's word. She wasn't going to let anything take her away from obtaining it. And if my memory serves me right, Martha got a little upset because she ended up doing it all. She even told Jesus to tell Mary to come and help her. Do you remember Jesus' response? "Martha, Martha, you are worried and upset about many things, but only one thing is needed. Mary has chosen what is better, and it will not be taken away from her." How valuable is Christ's kingdom? Very valuable. It's the most valuable thing in your life. May God the Holy Spirit keep reminding you of the value of Christ's kingdom, and then keep you safe and secure in its care. God grant it for Jesus' sake. Amen. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look on you with favor and give you peace.
Spending some time with us today. You have been watching First Evangelical Lutheran Church of the Wisconsin Evangelical Lutheran Synod. Reverend Thomas Rothy invites you to tune in again next week, or if you have the opportunity, to worship with us live on Sunday morning at 9:30. First Evangelical Lutheran Church is located at 231 Smoke Tree Lane, Prescott, Arizona. If you are in need of spiritual assistance or would just like more information, please call 445-2807. May God's word guide you this week.